I'm Steve Cook, bodybuilding.com spokesmodel, optimal nutrition athlete, the 2010 bodybuilding.com fit body winner, the 2010 muscle and fitness male model winner, as well as a IFBB Pro men's physique competitor. Before I was any of that, I was a collegiate athlete where I earned my bachelor's degree in biology, psychology, integrated studies. This is the Big Man on Campus 12-week college trainer. This is Goal Setting 101. Too many people enter school and the gym without a clear-cut goal.
You have to have that end result in sight.
I'll set short goals to kind of help me get to the biggest goal that I have.
My main goal, honestly, is just to be healthy, be the best me.
They start working out, but they don't have a concrete idea of whether they want to increase strength, lose body fat, gain size, or just run a faster mile.
You figure out what goals you want, and then you can tailor it around there. You tailor your diet around that. Tailor your workout around that.
I'm here to help you set, achieve, and exceed your goals. Take your seats, class is in session. In this class, we're gonna be covering the basics of goal setting, both short and long term, how to stick to your goals, how to find success when you feel like you're failing, how to get motivated, and more importantly, how to stay motivated. Is it important to define your goals before entering school? Tons of people out there know exactly what they want to study and what they want their careers to be. They know what they want their degree to be in. They're the lucky ones. They know right off the bat the career path they're gonna follow. But just because you may not know what you wanna study doesn't mean you shouldn't have some expectations on yourself. Setting expectations is very important. A 3.5 GPA is a great long-term goal. From there, you need to create a short-term plan that allows you to get to those goals. Not quite sure how to set up these short-term goals? Think of it like you would in working out. Let's say this semester, you want to gain 10 pounds. Well, that's the end goal. From there, you need to break it down into smaller steps. One thing you need to be doing is tracking your progress. Using something like BodySpace is a great way to track your long-term and short-term goals. It's right there in front of you. The work's been done. All you have to do is enter your stats, your exercises, and it's a great place to get motivated because you're surrounded by like-minded individuals. How do you stick to those goals? Well, take what you're not that excited about and make them applicable to your interests. If you're goal-minded, like on a competitive sports team where the common interest is in winning, you already have the drive to achieve something. Translate that into the classroom, turn a test into an opponent. Find your weak points, whether it's in your physique, in the classroom, or in your everyday life, and turn them into your strengths. You do this by identifying them and then working like hell to change them. There's so many things in life that you can apply what you've learned in the gym into your everyday routine. I once had a coach tell me that potential is a very scary thing because it sometimes allows us to slack. If you're one of those people with great potential, don't kid yourself. You still need to work hard. Hard work will always beat talent when talent doesn't work hard. Now that we've set some goals, let's talk about what happens if you fail to achieve those goals in the time you've set. Always remember, you never fail until you quit, until you decide that you're not going to change and just give up and quit. We can always reevaluate and reassess your goals. If you're working like hell, if you're visualizing and still find that you're coming up a little bit short, it's time to sit down and reevaluate some things. I came in as a freshman, wanted to start at running back. The coaches, they had some other thoughts in mind for me. They saw me as a linebacker, my build, my mentality, so they switched me over to the defensive side of the ball. Now this was very hard for me at the time. I was a great high school running back, had lots of accolades and awards, and I thought I could play running back. But I had to stop and think about what was best for me and what was best for the team. I eventually started all 4 years at linebacker and was so happy I decided to change my goals. If you do fail, don't look at it as a negative thing. You're just finding one more way not to do something. Some of the most successful people in history have been failures at multiple things, multiple times. But what they have is perseverance. They keep coming back harder and stronger. When I got to college, I failed my very first college class. It was the best thing that could have happened to me. It opened my eyes to show me that I couldn't get by just on potential alone. But I worked my butt off and eventually got a 3.5 throughout my college career. There'll be a lot of times in life where you're gonna come up short and even fail at things. Learn from your failures, whether it's on the field, in the gym, or in the classroom. You only fail if you give up. I often get asked, are there any shortcuts? My answer is always the same. Yes, there are, but no, they're not worth it. And you will see other people taking shortcuts, and it might seem like they are getting results, but in the long run, they're only hurting themselves. By taking shortcuts and the easy way out, you never realize how strong of a person you are, and you never live up to your full potential. Shortcuts, in the long run, end up making more work for you.
I often get asked, how do I stay motivated? You've started this program, now how do you make sure that you're getting the most out of every single workout? I'm not gonna lie, we all struggle, we all go through valleys, lows and highs with being motivated. But one thing you can do is you can go to other people around you. You have teachers, coaches, people in your class, people in the gym. All these people, look at them, if they're successful, emulate what they do. Arnold Schwarzenegger, he was a great inspiration for me. I remember watching Pumping Iron, I was addicted to it. Watched 15 minutes every night. Just seeing his passion and his enthusiasm, it's contagious. I would inundate myself with all of Arnold's training techniques, his way of life, the passion, and then I'd go into the gym and I'd feel like I was working out just like he was. Another great place to go is bodybuilding.com. They have so many great informational videos out there, so many trainers you can follow. Steal bits and pieces of everything that you like, make it work for you. Body Space is a great tool for motivation. Get on there, post progress pictures. Post your workouts, what's working, what's not working. Help inspire others as you also get inspired by other people. It's up to you to get motivated and stay motivated.
Once you've set your goals, make sure to tell your parents, teachers, fraternity brothers, roommates, or a girlfriend what they are. That way they can help keep you accountable and keep you on the right track.
I feel like, you know, when I finish college, you know, obviously I want to, you know, be very successful.
Set priorities and set goals and start small and just keep at it.
Setting goals definitely, it helps me to stay on track with what I ultimately want to do. It helps me to continually wake up every day and know why I'm doing it. It gives me reason to get out of bed.
I'm Steve Cook. Make sure to check out my other 5 Big Man on Campus video classes, as well as the 4 complete workout videos. If you have any questions, hit me up on Body Space, Steve Cook_32. Class dismissed.